Today I wanted to sink my teeth into a good, juicy American story, because my last two episodes were about Venezuela and Afghanistan. You know, let's talk about a government that I can confidently say will stay open for, let me check my calendar, yeah, probably the next 3 weeks. Specifically, we're talking about the Federal Reserve, an entity so mundane sounding that some of you might be wondering if you can go back to that ad. Maybe I should use Wix to make my next website. So why am I talking about the Federal Reserve today? I mean, didn't I just talk about them in January 5th? Well, what a difference 25 days makes, because the Fed is singing a very different tune today. They're now pursuing what's being described by Bloomberg as a sweeping pivot from its bias towards tighter monetary policy just last month. In this episode, I'm going to try to answer the question of why that change is happening and what it means. Jerome Powell made a speech on January 30th, and in the most telling response to a Federal Reserve chair speech, immediately after it, gold futures rose. So that is not a good sign. That would be like the head of the FDA giving a speech and then immediately afterward the price of Pepto-Bismol going through the roof. So what is going on?
The Federal Reserve leaves interest rates unchanged at 2.25% to 2.5%, no change. But the Fed says it will be, quote, patient in figuring out its next moves when it comes to interest rates.
MSNBC, you guys certainly are making your money back on that breaking news visual. I mean, this is important, but let's not rush into the town square screaming that the glacier is beginning to move in a different direction. A month ago, we were kings of the world saying,
many FOMC participants had expected that economic conditions would likely call for about 3 more rate increases in 2019. We have brought that down a bit and now think it is more likely that the economy will grow in a way that will call for 2 interest rate increases over the course of next year.
Well, we brought that number down hard this month to 0 interest rate increases for indefinite periods of time, with investors thinking we'll be making rate cuts by 2020. Now would probably be a pretty good time to talk about what this rate is. For the purposes of this episode, imagine that the economy is your friend. You want to keep him at normal, cool guy level. You know, a guy who you can hang out with. But if he starts succeeding too much, he'll turn into a bit of a douche, so you have to neg him back down to normal levels. At the same time, if your friend is sad, you have to encourage him and try to bring him back to that normal level. When the Fed raises interest rates, it's basically telling your friend, hey, you think you're all that in a bag of chips right now, huh? Well, things are gonna start slowing down, so you're gonna need to be prepared. On the other hand, when the Fed lowers rates, it's saying to your friend, hey buddy, I know you're on hard times right now, but you have savings. So go out and spend some of it, cheer up, and let's get you back on your feet. Basically, if I were to explain this to Frankenstein, I would say rate hikes, good economy. Rate cuts, bad economy.
Our Federal Reserve is raising rates too fast because they think our economy is too good. And I say, I don't want you to, every time we announce a good quarter, you have to raise interest rates. I don't want that. I'm very unhappy with the Federal Reserve.
For a while, Trump has been consistently railing against the Fed for raising rates, which has put him in quite the odd position. We're in the greatest economy ever, record low unemployment, but Federal Reserve? It's really not that great. Why pause rate hikes now though, Jerome Powell? Don't pity us, have you seen our employment rate?
The jobs picture continues to be strong, with the unemployment rate near historic lows, and with stronger wage gains. Inflation remains near our 2% goal. We continue to expect that the American economy will grow at a solid pace in 2019, although likely slower than the very strong pace of 2018.
Now, to be fair, his announcement didn't say the Fed is lowering rates. It just said, hey America, your outlook is good, just no longer too good. Keep up the decent work. A few reasons were given for this, each inspiring varying degrees of, oh god, let me just get all my money into gold and slip into this bunker until I run out of canned goods. The first reason is inflation, and it's the don't panic answer to this question.
Over the past few months, that risk appears to have diminished. Inflation readings have been muted, and the recent drop in oil prices is likely to push headline inflation lower still in coming months.
So let's go back to your friend to explain this one, because right now he's riding high on this great new promotion, so he's got money to burn, baby! $5 a burger, $10 a burger, it doesn't matter to him. Just take his money and give him something good. He's even going to those restaurants where the menus don't even have prices. So that getting a check is just a little fun surprise at the end. Great, leaving the prices to my imagination. The fact that we have increasing employment, increasing wages, and stagnant inflation shows that that is not happening. Which is a bit of a weird situation, because economists always just assume people spend money like a rapper who's about to be bankrupt in a nightclub. The Fed's primary goal is to keep inflation in check, and because customers are not willing to spend more per item despite apparent increases in wages and jobs, well, the Fed doesn't feel the same amount of pressure to tell us to cool it with the spending just a little and save some. It's not as though they're asleep at the wheel, though.
In this environment, we believe we can best support the economy by being patient in evaluating the outlook before making any future adjustment to policy.
So they're going to wait for the symptoms to show up before they give us a cure. That sounds like a logical response. At the same time, you don't rapidly shift your rate policies over the course of a month because inflation is continuing to not be a problem. It was as much of a non-issue last month when we were going to keep raising rates. So now to the part of the conversation where Jerome Powell starts listing out problems like a particularly dark remix of the We Didn't Start the Fire song.
Elevated uncertainty around several unresolved government policy issues, including Brexit, ongoing trade negotiations, and the effects from the partial government shutdown in the United States. Financial conditions tightened considerably late in 2018 and remain less supportive of growth than they were earlier in 2018.
Isn't it just great to hear all this bad news from someone with the charisma of Microsoft Sam on a bad day? Wait, there's more!
Elevated uncertainty around several unresolved government policy issues, including Brexit, ongoing trade negotiations, and the effects from the partial government shutdown in the United States. Financial conditions tightened considerably late in 2018 and remain less supportive of growth than they were earlier in 2018.
Yeah, I'd like to put all my money in gold right now. Thing is, none of that is bad on its own. Well, except for the global economic slowdown that, for now, seems to have skipped us. Each of those items he listed are things that could go wrong, but have economists rooting for status quo. Ah yes, hoping for status quo, the rooting for defense of the economics world. Forget points on the board, let's just not lose. This is why caution and patience were the Fed's word of the day. Nothing policy-wise will change until we figure out exactly what's changing in the world. So now to a final piece of the puzzle that is a little counterintuitive. Hedge fund managers, financial pundits, and other professional fortune tellers got a pretty strong message in their tea leaves from this announcement. Yeah, let's not stir that anymore. Buying stocks was the name of the game.
Federal Reserve's decision on interest rates, which has provided the most recent boost to U.S. equity markets.
So why, in a time of economic uncertainty, is this Fed announcement leading to a buying spree? Well, to explain that, let's go back to your friend one more time, who seems to be doing very well right now money-wise. What this new Fed statement just said was, everything seems to be going pretty well right now, and you're not blowing your money driving up prices. So I'm going to stop encouraging you to save and instead continue incentivizing you to borrow money. But warily. Quick warning, if this sounds like a recipe for asset bubbles, it definitely is. Our interest rate is still around the height of the recession levels with the growing economy and record jobs, while the Fed is waiting for the shoe to drop to act. This period in Fed policy is very strange and is being mired by the lack of information, not only about what is going to happen, but what's currently happening. Because of the shutdown.
Let's not forget, of course, a large chunk of the data that the Fed's going to rely on also isn't going to be published either.
Yeah, they were working with minimal recent data, so I guess it's a good thing fiscal policymakers are hanging out in the corner until the lights turn on instead of firing wildly into the dark. I'm not going to make any predictions for the future because I'm not a fortune-telling stock market guru who can make you $1 billion but somehow isn't a billionaire themselves. The only thing my cup of coffee is telling me is that I need more sleep. I'll just say that there's a lot of uncertainty right now, and it looks like the Fed is either bracing for impact or caving to the will of the president's desire for continued unchecked expansion. And honestly, I'm not sure which answer to hope for. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe and ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring. To understand more about what the Fed rate actually is, click here. And to understand what happens when the Fed doesn't raise rates as the economy grows, click here. Remember to give me a thumbs up, and as always, thank you for watching.